During the next 5 minutes, I'll make the case for why pushing for divestment at the University of Toronto should remain a priority for Toronto350.org, as well as make the pitch for why you should help. First, I'm going to explain why this campaign matters. Then, I'll describe some of the most important work that remains to be done. So, why does this campaign matter? Divestment is at the very heart of what we need to do to control climate change. We need to stop building inappropriate high-carbon infrastructure and redirect investment toward climate-safe forms of energy. Divestment by the University of Toronto would set an important precedent. U of T has a $2.1 billion endowment and a $3.2 billion pension fund, and if it chose to divest, it would become the first big public university to do so, as well as the first school in Canada to do so. The people who would pay attention to such a decision extend far beyond universities and include every important category of large institutional investor, including hedge funds, private foundations, pension funds, and so on. So, what should we do? The University of Toronto has a specific set of policies and procedures for divestment. We've been waiting now since March for the president to appoint an ad hoc committee to consider the issue and make a recommendation. We expect this committee to assemble soon. The first major type of activity that we need to undertake now is engaging with the committee. We need to update the brief to include important new material from the last 6 months. We need to line up members from the university community to appear as witnesses or to provide written statements to the committee. And we need to respond to the arguments against divestment that are going to be raised by others. Once the committee makes a recommendation to the president will make a decision on whether to divest or not. And that decision will either be affirmed or overturned by the governing council of the university. So getting to know the members of the governing council is an important strategy for our success. I think we want to be meeting with them one-on-one for lunch or for coffee to make the case for divestment and to answer any questions that they have. And for people who'd be interested in helping with that work, I'm willing to do some joint meetings or joint lunches where me and another Toronto350.org member meet with a member of the governing council so that people who are interested in doing this sort of work will get a sense of what's involved and gain some confidence before they do it on their own. Beyond the committee itself, there are lots of things that we can do to build support in the community. We can organize on-campus events that will make students more aware of the campaign and try to gain their support. We can encourage them to contact the Office of the President or the committee or the Governing Council. We can continue to reach out to media outlets, both on campus and more broadly. And quite importantly, we could start a campaign among alumni and donors, possibly where they pledge to donate whatever amount of money at such a time as the university commits to divestment. Now, beyond this, there's definitely scope for other ideas. So if you have another idea for some way in which we can improve the odds of divestment at U of T, please let me know, or ideally, you know, start thinking about how we can make it happen together. Divestment by U of T would have a huge impact. All over the world, universities and other investors are worried about climate change in terms of what it means for their portfolios in the long term. But at the same time, they're nervous about being one of the first institutions to do something new. So every big precedent makes it easier for everybody else to take the same step, whether they're universities or other kinds of investors. So success at U of T would raise the odds of success everywhere else.